Father, we thank you and we bless you. Grant us the mighty anointing tonight that we can break any foundation of the demonic powers. In Jesus' name, amen. You may be seated. Church, could you help me thank the father and the mother of this house? Let's show our love to him. Let's show our love to them. Amen. You may be seated. Let me bring a special greeting from my wife. She wanted to come with us, but she's preaching on Sunday in our church in New Jersey. Then the following day, we have to fly back to Ghana. So permit me to leave her. And first March will be her birthday. Yes. It's wonderful. And first March is your papa's 20 years in marriage. Yes, announce it. Our mom has an okro mouth. Yes. So, on the first March, I want the whole church, please show your love to Papa and Mama. Oh, wow. And to be honest with you, by the grace of God, I've been in the ministry almost 35 years now. Wait. I always call him young boy because he will grow young until Jesus comes. And I've walked around this world to see a young man like this whose family is so important to him. I personally admire him. Come on, check, talk to me. Yes, it's a few people like this. Let me be honest with you. He's someone that I'm not afraid to walk with him. Because he has nothing to hide. Yes. And when the wife came to Ghana recently, I took her and the two daughters. Yes. Next time I will take him. And we had lunch together, yes. After that, people were calling me, said, "Hey, Papa, this lady," and I said, "Me, I don't need invitation to go to her." But one of my people said that, "I've been to their church. I love the way she talks to her husband." Come on, church. Am I making sense to somebody? Amen. So how many of you appreciate this family? So bless you. Wow. Somebody shout hallelujah. Okay, you may be seated. Tonight, my sermon is very simple. And I don't want to detain you here. But I will preach powerful. Tonight, tomorrow, and Friday, I'm going to lead you into a time of warfare. Amen. Somebody say, "I will fight and win."
I will fight and win.
I can't hear you. I will fight and win.
I will fight and win.
You have no idea when prophets said that these 21 days, the theme is, "I will heal the land." You have no idea. Let me first of all give you a clear meaning. Number one, what he declared, he's telling you and I that we are recovering from our lost power. Amen. The power that we lost through these 21 days, we are recovering it. And the purpose of recovering that power is to destroy demonic powers.
Amen.
You didn't, you, oh. Number two, listen. Pharaoh said, in this land, you Israelites, you are under my control. All the females in this land, when you give birth to male boys, all the boys should be killed. These 21 days, listen to me carefully. I'm here to let you know, don't let what you are hearing here in America scare you. Listen, it happened in Liberia during the Civil War. It was so pathetic that the soldiers were killing people, killing them like that, killing them. And a family had, a family of, I think, the father, the mother, and three children, yes. Two boys, one girl. The father doesn't go to church. The mother doesn't go to church. The boy don't go to church. It's only the girl. So the soldiers went to their house, killed the mother, killed the father, killed the two boys. And the girl said, oh, why? Listen, church, I'm here to let you know these 21 days, don't let what you are hearing scare you.
Amen.
If you know your God, somebody say, I know my God. I can't hear, come and say, oh. Then the following day, the girl was standing in front of their house and the soldiers were coming. The girl said, well, my father is gone, my mother is gone, my two brothers is gone. Well, me, I won't go. I have purpose in my heart to serve the Lord. Wait. About 15 soldiers with their gun, they came and they saw the girl. They said, hey, lady, come. Do you know something? We made a mistake to kill your parents. But you, we are not going to kill you. Stay in this house. Every day, every day we are going to bring food to you, prepare it, and all of us will come and eat in this house. Listen, why do you let, listen, beloved, I'm here to let you know God will change things.
Amen.
In Germany, one of our church members called Sammy. Sammy doesn't have even toilet roll to stay in Germany. No people, so one day he was walking. Level go change. How many of you believe that I'm making sense? That time when you see a police car in Germany, you run. So Sammy saw the police car, he was running, and the policemen were chasing. He said, hey, stop. Sammy stopped. He said, today I finished. He said, hey, you are not finished. We have been looking for you. Every day you take bus from this junction. For almost 3 years, the time that you take the bus, the time that you come, the time that you go to your house, we know everything. How best can we help you in this country? Somebody say, love will go change. I can't hear you say, love will go change. How many of you believe that I am making sense? You see, oh my God. Hey, amen. It doesn't happen in Germany, but the policeman helps Sammy. Change the toilet through. Give him a proper document. Now, Sammy can boast. He said, And Sammy, the secret of that success was that in the church, every Sunday he would come around 6 a.m. and clean the toilets. Clean the toilets. You see, oh my God. If God has not assigned that you should go to Africa, nobody can take you.
Amen.
Am I making sense? Well, this is just introduction. Okay. Tonight, I want to talk about frustrating demonic agendas.
Amen.
Good. How many of you are ready to frustrate demonic agenda?
Amen.
You may not understand why things are not going well with you. Prophet declared these 21 days because we are frustrating demonic agendas.
Amen.
Turn with me to Luke chapter 10. In Luke chapter number 10, glory. Well, this is my home, so I feel at home. Good, 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 good. In Luke chapter 10, verse number 19, Jesus said, "Behold, I give you power." Say, "Behold."
Behold.
My brother, hurry up and bring it on the screen. Okay. Say, "Look." Somebody say, "Look."
Look.
Okay, let's read together. 1, 2. "Look, I've given you the authority to trample on snakes and scorpions, and over all the power of the enemy, nothing will harm." Say, "Nothing will harm me." Says again, say, "Nothing will help me." Recently, Bishop Oyedepo was having a convention, and he called one of his members, a good man, a billionaire. The man has money, but this man is not married. He called him and saw that this man is wearing ladies' skirts. "I'm here to let you know it's time to frustrate demonic agendas." You see, I always come to this church, but yet this evening, when Stanley parked the car, I turned to the door. I saw fire, real fire. I saw fire. I saw fire from this place going out. Oh my God. Yellow. Hallelujah. And it happened, listen, oh glory. The verse that prophet has quoted for these 21 days, some of you don't take it for granted. The Lord said, "Solomon, as you dedicate this house to me, fire from heaven will come." And just about 30 minutes ago, I've witnessed the fire. May the fire, may the fire. Someone said, "Let the fire fall." Come on, say, "Let the fire fall, let the fire." Hallelujah. You have no idea what is fighting against you. So when Bishop said that, "Hey man, why do you wear lady skirts?" This man has proposed to not less than 50 women in the church. Not knowing that the woman, they see the man as their own. Come on, talk me. Hello.
Yes.
And the man had been worrying. I said, "What is happening? I'm a man. I have money. I can do everything. Why is it that I'm not married?" Not knowing that in the spiritual realm, he was wearing ladies' skirts. "Behold, I give you power." Say, "Power."
Power.
Come on, say, "Power."
Power.
Listen, I'm here to let you understand. Sometimes, some things close to you, you will see it. Before these 21 days is over, there are two kinds of prophetic anointing that is going to be released in this house.
Yeah.
Oh, somebody shout hallelujah. Jason, come. Jason, come. Glory. The Lord said from today, not only that you will speak, but you will see.
Amen.
Glory. You see, some of you are used to prophetic ministry that only speaks. Isn't it? When I called and said, well, that's the Lord. The Lord said, that's why you are happy. But there is some prophetic dimension. The Lord is taking this guy to that dimension. Oh, my God. Somebody shout hallelujah. Listen. When I pour this oil on this guy, Jason, from today, may the seer's anointing fall on you. Can I have a witness? Can I have a witness? Oh, glory. Yeah. And from today, whoever greet this boy, the CS anointing will touch you. Because you need the CS anointing to discover what the devil is doing. And from today, may the CS anointing be released in this house. Can I have a witness in the house, please? If you believe it, shout hallelujah. Come on, say shout hallelujah. Prophet, help me. Mama, please help me. Glory. your own son, from today, the thing that he will see and tell you, you'll be amazed. And from today, not only to see, but God through your dreams will speak to you. Let me close. Mama, this way. Yes. Do me a favor. Hold this hand. Papa, hold this hand. Everybody, stretch your hands on this. Debro sa, parandebro kotobri kalasata. May your eyes be open. Open. Leave him. Take your seat. Glory. Leave him. Am I making sense to somebody?
Yes.
You see, I believe in... of late, you see, the thing that some people are saying about prophets is so bad. Thank God you have a good prophet. Look at him. Don't touch him. Go. I bless you. Glory. Jason, where's your sister? The one next to you. Come. From today, the Holy Ghost will arrest you. Something that the enemy planned to do. That thing was coming from all the four corners. But when the thing was getting close to you, they saw a fire around you. Fire. But listen, you are weak in prayer. You are weak. From today, a new strength is coming to you. The Holy Ghost will arrest you.
Amen.
You'll be on your knees praying. By the time you are aware, 2 hours, 3 hours is gone.
Amen.
Because people are looking up to you because you are a leader.
Amen.
Come on, church. Can I preach more? And I hear God saying that your life is going to be an example. But I have to prepare you.
Amen.
Oh, glory to God. The Lord is taking the old garment from you.
Amen.
Washing you.
Amen.
Very soon, the Boaz that will come your way.
Amen.
Hey, check. Receive that impartation in the name of Jesus. Amen.
Amen.
You may be seated. Can I preach more?
Yes.
Okay. How many of you are ready to frustrate demonic agenda?
Hallelujah.
Yes. Recently, one of my church members, when you see him, you might think that maybe this guy has nothing. That's why I'm saying that sometimes some things close to you, God will not reveal it to you. Sometimes. I've been praying for our church because I'm trusting God not less than 3,500 people. And the building, we are almost done. And the guy came to me, he said, Papa, do you know something? Last night I dreamt and I saw three bulldogs. Dogs. Standing in front of the door. And thousands of people were standing behind the wall. And because of the dogs, they were afraid to enter the church. I said, Lord, have mercy on me. Our church, your own church. Then I declared 3 days. Prayer and fasting. Church, how many of you are ready to frustrate demonic agendas? At your age, nobody's coming to marry you. Hello. Say hello. You see, somebody, you are here, you are angry with everyone close to you. You think that they are causing the trouble. It's you. Don't look at me. It's you. And Bishop, that night, the last night, I picked an oil, bottle of oil, went straight to, come. Chris, hurry up. Carry it well and come.
Okay, no problem.
Masa, I'm in business, so. Ask someone to carry it, brought it to the door, and I said, open it, pour it on the door, pour it high, and I could hear dogs barking. Bow, 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 bow. Behold, I give you power. Say power. Say power. Somebody after tonight's service, while you were sleeping, you could see a big snake running out of your house. Somebody, you will see a snake on your compound. It's a sign that you are frustrating demonic. Listen, listen. That's why I will encourage you. I mean, today is Wednesday. Yes. Do your best. I said, do your best.
Amen.
And fast.
Amen.
If I have my own power, I will ask prophet that tomorrow by 5 a.m. we should open the door. And I'll be here. Sit here and pray. Because I've realized that the thing that are fighting against me, if I joke with prayer and fasting, I'll die soon. But thank God, I won't die now. That's why I'm here to let you know that it's time to frustrate demonic agenda. Hello. A boy of 16 years told his own mother, he said, Mom, my teacher taught me how to make sex. Mom, can I have sex with you? Listen, what is happening? Behold, I give you power. Say power.
Power.
Somebody say power past power.
Power.
I can't hear. Come and say power past power.
Power.
Glory. Glory to God. Let me stop. That guy over there, you, yes, come. No, yeah, the one with the beard, come. Bishop, help me. Mm.
sorry, Chris.
May your eyes be open. Receive. Somebody shout hallelujah. Leave him, he will sleep. Leave him. Let him sleep. Hallelujah. Listen, Chris is praying, but it's like he needs strong faith. Amen. My brother, you are a nice guy, highly intelligent guy. Highly intelligent. But the enemy, help me. Put the oil somewhere, Charlie. No, you are not strong. You come. Carry me, carry me. Ah, no, 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 no. Oh, I'm sorry. Carry here. Not here. Ah, no, wait, wait. I want to do something. Okay, kneel down. Okay. Brother, you are highly intelligent. But the enemy has put a leg on you. Sometimes you are confused. Let me close. Can I preach more? Three people are discussing about you. And right now, what I'm hearing is that they are saying that you, for you to get to the top, you have to be like us. But the Lord said, I've made a covenant with you. And the covenant that I made with you, you will stay on top. And right, you see, oh glory. In this prayer and fasting, you say, Lord, show me your glory. Amen. The Lord said, this is the time for me to show you my glory. Amen. And today, because you have obeyed God to come to the church, that leg has been removed. Amen. Listen, from now, somebody close to you will provoke you. Don't talk. Amen. When you see the thing coming, don't talk. Say, Lord, guard my heart. Amen. And close my mouth. Amen. Because when you get angry, sometimes you can't control your temper. You. And the enemy is using that thing to make your life stagnant. Let me close. Papa, can you please give this guy a water to drink? Bring your gum. Bring it. Put it in your pocket. Somebody say power.
Power.
Come on, say power.
Power.
Papa, give him water to drink. Stand up. You. Come. Run. Go. Take it to your house, eh? The water, take it to your house. Before Sunday, the Lord would amaze you. In prayer, you'll be crying. Beloved, some people, the Lord said, forgive them. Forgive them.
Amen.
Go in peace.
Amen.
This guy is rich, old. He's rich.
Wow!
Charlie, you are rich. Are you married? Be careful with the ladies. Be very, very, very careful with the ladies. Let me close. It's 9 o'clock. Let me close. Level. It's a level. This lady, come.
Amen.
Come. I need strong men. So you work on me today. But I will deal with them. You see, this lady, in the spirit, she's strong. Very, very strong. Today I will deal with that spirit. I think I have to stop. Don't go. Hey. Take your clock, go. Go. Can I preach more?
Yeah.
But tonight, when you see that I'm delaying you, please, because I've opened the Bible, just bring your offering and go home. Because I've opened the Bible. Because tonight, tomorrow night, and Friday night, beloved, we are frustrating demonic agenda. You see, this man, glory, it's like a graveyard cloth. It's around him. He wants to step forward, but something hinders him. He's a nice guy, very, very, very nice guy. Nice guy. The Lord said, don't entertain fears again.
Amen.
Go. Go to Papa. Glory. Glory. What is it? The shadow of the Almighty. And this one? This one? Where did you get it? Omega. From where? Mecca. Omega. From where? Here in the church. Nigeria. So you are here the same time here. So why do you carry two things? I'm serious. Take it. We close every door for the demonic powers to attack you.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus, whatever has possessed you, come and rebuke it. Thank you, Lord. Go. Go. Leave her. Leave her. Go back. Glory to God. Church, let me close. Let me quickly give you three areas that the enemy carries his works against you so that you can learn to frustrate demonic agenda. Chris, sit here.
Thank you.
Sit there. You go. Sit there. Chris, from today,
amen.
God is changing your shoes.
Amen.
From tonight, the devil and his mother-in-law, they are in trouble.
Amen.
Say, they are in trouble.
Amen.
Come on, say, they are in trouble.
Trouble.
Somebody say, power.
Power.
Come on, say, power.
Jesus
said, behold, I give you power to tread upon. Glory. Quickly, I want to show you areas that the enemy uses to bring his agendas against you. And if I have enough time, I also give you the keys to frustrate it. The first one, note it well, the quotation that prophet has given to us in these 21 days. The Lord spoke to Solomon. He says, Solomon, the house that you are dedicating to me, there you will make sacrifices, that it will become a memorial to me. And when my people who are called by my name shall humble themselves, turn from their wicked ways, pray and seek my face, I will heal their land.
Amen.
If God wants us to sacrifice to him, some of you must sacrifice your time.
Amen.
You see, let me tell you, the reason why this President Trump came is that Christians, God wants us to pray.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
I'm throwing that challenge to each one of you. David said, early will I seek thee, and early will I find thee. The Lord said, if you will bring sacrifices to me in my temple, then Solomon tell my people that when they call me, I will answer.
Amen.
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 When Mama came to Ghana, me and my wife took them tonight, and I was interviewing her. I discovered that she has sacrificed her children to God.
Amen.
From today, learn to sacrifice whatever to God. Oh, my God, my God. Come on, come on, come on. Am I making sense to somebody?
Yes.
Glory. When you turn to numbers, please sit there. You two, sit there. Sit. Sit there. Sit there until I finish preaching. Glory to God. Oh. When you turn to Numbers 23, glory. Numbers 23, verse 1 to 2. Sir, hurry up for me. Numbers 23, verse 1 to 2. The first area or the first thing that the enemy uses to fight against you and I, the church, the families, is through what I call glory. Okay, let's read together. Then Balaam said to Balak, build me 7 altars here and prepare 7 bulls and 7 rams for me. Listen, Balaam told Balak, said, build me altars. So the first area the enemy uses to fight against you is erecting altars. And tonight, every demonic altar is going to be destroyed.
Amen.
Oh, come on, come on, come on, come on. You see, if I have enough time, I think let me stop here. Let me give, because I want to give you PowerPoints. I love teaching. So when altars are erected against you, the first thing you experience, you will have financial trouble. Financially, you are handicapped. But tonight, we will destroy every altar. I say, we will destroy every altar. I said, we will destroy every altar.
Amen.
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 Last year, when Papa came to Ghana, I went to his house. We're sitting by his, the swimming pool, talking. I interviewed him and I said, I greeted him. I said, how do you manage to build this house? He said, I watched some film, I tap in. I said, wow, thank God, I'm building the same building, yes, in my house. Yes, I will soon finish it. Why? Because, you see, do your best and work with people who are successful. It doesn't matter, maybe you give birth to them. It doesn't matter. All what you want is blessing, isn't it? Come on, talk to me. When altars are erected against you financially, you'll be struggling. Number two, when altars are erected, things will delay. Whatever is delaying your marriage, oh my God, yeah, your promotion. There are some families, because the altars have been erected in that family, people can't get married. And even if you get married, it won't last. How many of you are ready to destroy the altars of the demonic? Oh, come on. Say amen to this. Master, come. Come. Greet me 3 times and go back. Just greet me. Sit down.
Amen.
You do well,
Amen.
You do well.
Amen.
Charlie, you do well.
Amen.
How many of you are ready to destroy satanic altars?
Amen.
I think about 2 weeks ago, Pastor Benihin was in Ghana. Yeah, he prayed for, yes. Benihin and Pastor Chris were in Ghana. He prayed for Ghana and declared that since that night that he prayed for us, prosperity will be spread on our streets.
Amen.
And I see the same thing happening to you now. I see the same thing happening to you now. I see the same thing happening to you now. Somebody shout hallelujah. I said, somebody shout hallelujah. How many of you are ready to destroy demonic altars? You see, Balak told Balaam, he said, build me altars. Altars. And through that altars, I will use it to fight against people. Yeah. When altars are erected against a ministry, somebody shout hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
You see, I was watching the YouTube of Pastor Benihin when he came to Ghana. He called Archbishop Dr. Williams. He said, sir, I think I've heard your name, but I've not seen you. Then Archbishop said that we met this ability, and how he anointed Archbishop, man. He said, receive the mighty anointing.
Amen.
And I said, Father, I tap into this anointing.
Amen.
Somebody said, I tap into this anointing. I can't hear someone say, I tap into this anointing. Give somebody high five and say, I tap into this anointing. I say, high five. Stand up and do it well. Come on.
I tap into it, sir.
Come on, glory. Come on. Yes, I'm preaching. Receive it. Receive it. Receive it. Amen. Oh.
Level.
Church, am I making sense?
Yes.
Glory to God.
Hallelujah.
That sister, you, yes. Stand there, don't come here. My dear, let me speak into your life. As a father, from today, learn to humble yourself. Are you hearing me? If you learn to humble yourself, you do well.
Amen.
Number two, simple obey instruction.
Amen.
When we ask you to sit here, sit there. Don't ask the reason why you should sit there. It's your problem. Sit down. How many of you love me? If you don't love me, I love myself. So better clap for Jesus and we go. How many points have I given to you? Are you sure two?
Yes.
Oh, wow. Listen. Let me sit down because, you see, I didn't come here tonight just to, I came purposely to help you to pray. And I will make sure I won't take your time. And I came here to pray myself. Oh, come on, church. Amen.
Amen.
When altars are erected, number three, there's always premature death. Don't die before your time. Somebody say, I won't die before my time. Come on, say it again. Hallelujah. There are some people, as you are here, you see, God has connected your blessing with this church. If not because of this church and the pastor is leading this church, the enemy will have taken your life long time. That's what the Bible says, that they, those that are planted in the house of God, they will flourish. Oh, come on, church. Glory, glory, glory. Come. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord Jesus. Thank you, Lord Jesus. Rebe Soto. Thank you, Lord. Amen. This year, may God give you the strength.
Amen.
To endure to the end.
Amen.
No premature death.
Amen.
Somebody shout hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
I say somebody shout hallelujah. Am I making sense to someone?
Yes.
A pastor had a vision that he was admitted at the hospital. And Papa, a doctor opened his heart. And glory. They opened the heart. The doctor was bringing out tissue from the heart. And the pastor counted it. Almost 100,000. 100,000. And when he woke up, he found that his light. And he heard a voice, "Today I've healed you."
Amen.
Beloved, I'm here to announce to you, tonight we are ready to destroy satanic altars.
Yes.
Amen.
Amen.
When I discovered this secret, in my family, an altar was erected that no man should get a peaceful marriage. I witnessed it the first year and the second year of my marriage. I witnessed it. My wife and I will be in the house and she'll ask me money and I'll get angry for nothing. Hello.
Hi.
Say hello.
Hello.
When I realized that this altar had been erected in that family, I destroyed it. The day that the altar was destroyed, beloved, up to date, a lady in our family has never talked to me. Has never talked to me. I'm here to let you know, tonight, because of you, some people have to die. I don't care who will die. Because we are frustrating demonic agenda. Listen, do you know that an altar was erected against this church? Hey, let me tell you, there was a time Papa was confused. He doesn't know what to take the ministry to. But one day, while he was in prayer, the Holy Spirit encouraging him. Yes. This hallelujah business, beloved, is not easy. The accusation that has come upon him, eh? Some people even think that he's using juju. Can juju do this work?
No.
Oh, hallelujah. I say hallelujah.
Amen.
Come on, church. Glory. Wow. Wow. Glory. Can I preach more?
Yes.
Then one day, I asked my wife to pray for me. While she was praying for me, Papa, I saw a chain loose my waist. Loose my waist. Because an altar was erected in that family. I had an uncle who had almost 72 years. This man did never sleep with any woman. 72 years. And he would be walking, he fell down, boom. Sometimes you see him entering his own house, but he himself can't enter the house. That's why Jesus said, before you go to the strong man's house, you must first bind him. Tonight, how many of you are ready to bind the strong man? Come. Come. Sweetheart, your time has come, but the enemy wants to change your time. The Lord said, your time has come. Whatever your hand finds to do in this church, do it well. Do it well. Eh? If I were you, I would sacrifice my time to God. Glory. You see, there was some darkness ahead of you. But through this 21 days prayer and fasting, a new light has appeared on your way. Do you know how to sing? She sings? Through your singing, burden will be lifted from people. Robro Sibita. Church, I think I'm done. No, trust me, I'm done. I'm done. Oh, yes. Cut her. I'm done. Glory. Wait, sir. Wait. Somebody help her. Help her. Oh, my God. Bring that lady. Bring her. Glory, bro, sir. Last CK. Thank you, Lord. Thank you. Oh, glory. Hey. You see, tonight is not shouting service. Oh. How many of you enjoy the service? Yes. Listen, tomorrow, God willing, we are not going to, I'll suggest, I saw the flyers that the service starts at 7 o'clock. Eh? If I were you, by 6 o'clock, I'm here. Please, on Friday, the Lord wants me to tell somebody, take that Friday out of your work. Stay in this house. Bring your cloth. Bring your soap. Bring your everything. Sleep here. Because Friday is a new anointing. I shoot you into your blessing. Yeah. I shoot you into your blessing. Somebody said demonic altars. Stand up. Leave her. Papa, water, please. Papa, water. Glory. Glory. Thank you, Papa. Thank you. More water, Papa. Third one. Thank you. Thank you, Lord. It's done. Shout hallelujah. Say shout hallelujah. Somebody lift your right hand and say, Father, tonight,
any altar
erected against me, tonight, I frustrate it. I frustrate it. Any altar erected against my finances, my family, my destiny, in the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. Please stand well. Stand well. I want you to stand well. Get out of your seat today. Hey. We are sick and tired. That some of you, you come to church, you listen to us, then you go. Today, I will force you to pray. And while you are praying, some of you will see Jesus. Between now and Sunday, some of you are going to see Jesus. Somebody say Jesus. Come on, say Jesus. And somebody, you are here, between now and Sunday, you will see the prophet in your dream speaking prophetic things into your life. Now, please, when you wake up, write it down, bring it to the altar, and pray. It will come to pass one by one. The month of March, leave her, sweetheart, leave her. Sleep now. Let us sleep. Thank you, Lord. Listen, I told you that between now and Sunday, God is giving us two types of anointing. The prophetic anointing that speaks, and the CS anointing that see. Receive that anointing. I say, receive that anointing. Somebody say, I'll receive it. You see, oh God, right now I can see this lady like a beautiful flower. Beautiful flower, but nobody is coming to pick the flower. But the Lord said, it's over.
Amen.
Papa, I don't know her so much, but I can see how much you love this girl. A heart that you have for her to do well. May the Father's blessing come upon you.
Amen.
Glory. Amen. From today, she'll receive a call, telephone call. It's a good news.
Amen.
How many of you want to hear good news? Glory. Listen, I'm going to give you 10 minutes. Say 10 minutes.
10 minutes.
If you want to step forward here, you can step forward. Why ministries are not being fruitful? Because there's an altar erecting against it. Hello. Pastor Matthew Ashimolo, it was 15 years that he had a breakthrough. 15 years. Listen, glory. This place is too small for Restoration Chapel International. Very soon, I can see and I can hear. Some people will mention Prophet's name at the White House. They will mention his name there. Church, let me say it again. About an hour ago, the fire that I saw coming, the fire! And this fire is unquenchable. Because, church, glory. If I have enough time, I will have given you 10 things that happen when altar is erected against you. But I'm going to ask you to pray. Come and lift your right hand and say, Father,
Father,
in the name of Jesus, tonight,
any altar
erected against me, mention your name, me. Three times. Mention your name three times. Tonight, I break it.
I destroy it.
It won't work again. Any altar erected against my finances. Tonight, any altar erected against my children, my husband, my wife, myself, my family. Tonight, Father, as I stand before you, as I stand before your throne, I'm a covenant child. Tonight, now, any demonic altar, I destroy it. Come on. Be clapping. Be serious. Don't stand at one place. Be serious. I said, be serious. Destroy it. Rebrosirata.
Thank you, Lord.
Come on, please. Come out from your chair. Come out from your chair. As you pray, any altar erected against, come out from your chair and pray.